Welcome Wendy and Magdalena to enlightED 2021. We can't wait to hear your insights. The floor is yours.
Hello Wendy, it is a great pleasure to speak with you today. Thank you very much for participating in this session.
Thank you so much. It's such an honor and congratulations to you on this recognition.
Thank you. Education is currently at the center of the public debate as it has never been before. This can be positive as big changes are needed in the field of education, but at the same time, it is a complex issue. We run the risk to get lost in the debates or what is even worse, to end up making changes that will not improve the overall situation of education around the world. Our challenge today at this session is to hopefully contribute with some ideas and proposals that can be useful for this ongoing global debate about education. We might not come up with solutions, but I hope that at least we manage to give the audience some food for thought based on our experience. ProFuturo has worked for the last 5 years to bring quality digital education to the most vulnerable children around the world. Teach for All is a global network developing collective leadership to ensure all children have the opportunity to fulfill their potential. Wendy, how do you do that in Teach for All?
Well, Teach for All is a network, as you know, of independent, locally led organizations in 60 countries and growing, with a global organization to help all of them learn from each other. And what brings us together across the network is an understanding that the fact that the circumstances of children's birth predict their educational outcomes and life outcomes is a big systemic challenge that requires many changes, which requires, as we say, collective leadership, people, teachers, students, parents, school leaders, school system leaders, policy leaders, and everyone really around the whole ecosystem around children exerting leadership. So what these network organizations do is work to develop that leadership through enlisting people of all different academic backgrounds and all different career interests who are promising leaders to channel their energy into the arena of working with the most marginalized children, initially by committing 2 years to teach in under-resourced communities. They invest a lot in those teachers in pursuit of really important immediate outcomes for kids and also really important long-term outcomes, because those 2 years are foundational for really a lifetime of leadership and advocacy for children. So those teachers who commit just 2 years never leave the work, and they end up working in partnership with many others to effect the changes that we need from every level of the system and outside of the system as well.
This is really amazing, Wendy. The OECD published recently a report based on the results of the PISA assessment that showed that over the last two decades, there has been no real improvement in the learning outcomes of students across OECD countries. With no pandemic, and despite many educational reforms and rising expenditure. In 2019, the World Bank used the term learning poverty to give name to a terrible reality. 53% of 10-year-olds in low and middle-income countries were unable to read and understand a short text appropriate for their age, a figure that went over 80% in the poorest countries. It is clear that education was already in crisis before COVID-19 and that access to quality education is unequal. It is also obvious that the pandemic will only worsen this situation. Wendy, I have heard you before speaking about equity as a key in education. Could you explain this further?
You know, we think it's so key because all children have immense and unlimited potential, and yet whole segments of children in every part of the world are facing many extra challenges, as well as just systemic bias. And as a result, they aren't met with the expectations and provided with the supports they need to fulfill that potential. And we just know that our collective welfare really depends on all children having the education and support and opportunity necessary to develop the skills to create a better future, really, for all of us, to solve these increasingly complex problems that face us. And what I'll say too is that, you know, you can look at the OECD reports, you know, looking at aggregate progress, and it can become kind of depressing. But what fuels my sense of possibility and just sense of urgency in this, and all of us across the Teach for All network, is that we've seen that in some communities, we're making really significant progress. And what we've seen is that when we have enough people working together towards this end of ensuring all kids do fulfill their potential, we do see the kind of sustained aggregate progress for children that we need to see everywhere. So that's what keeps us going. Those communities show us what is possible, and they tell us that all of us can come together to improve the overall system.
That's really inspiring, Wendy. The side effects from the pandemic that we could consider positive has been that education is now at the center of the global debate. Due to the fact that we live in an interconnected and changing world, has made more obvious the need for a change in education. Education has to prepare children to thrive in the 21st century. Another learning from the pandemic has been that we have finally seen technology as a tool for education. The challenge we face now is that technology does not become an element to increase inequality. We can't allow that the most vulnerable are left behind. That's why in ProFuturo we believe that access to technology, at least in terms of education, is not enough. That is why we devote most of our efforts on teacher training. Over the past 5 years, we have trained over 900,000 teachers in 40 countries in Latin America, the Caribbean, Africa, and Asia. ProFuturo promotes the development of teachers' pedagogical and digital skills to enable them to integrate technology in the classroom and provide the best education to their students. At the end, it all comes down to the teachers, as they are the key, the engine for change. Wendy, what role do you think teachers should have in this new scenario?
Well, let me just say that across our network, we are so grateful for ProFuturo's initiative and your perspective on this, which we completely share. I think what we've seen in this era is that maybe we had underestimated the potential of technology to accelerate learning, to make learning more accessible. I think we had pre-pandemic. And what we've seen in this era is that it has so much potential. We can, you know, better differentiate learning to meet students' different needs. We can make it possible for everyone to access learning all the time. There are so many potentials. And yet, as you say, I've had the privilege of talking with so many teachers across our network who are leveraging the available technology to keep their kids learning, as well as to talk to some of the alumni of our program who have pioneered some of the most inspiring ed tech innovations. And each of these folks, one thing is clear. They say the technology is the easy part. The challenging part is developing ourselves and developing the teaching profession so that we know how to best leverage that technology to actually do good things for kids. As one of our alumni who started an innovation called Ed Puzzle said, you know, technology enhances either bad teaching or good teaching. Yeah. And so fundamentally, we need to make sure that all of our teachers have the pedagogical skills as well as the technology skills in order to actually help students develop both the academic and the social emotional skills necessary to get where we're all trying to go.
ProFuturo and several members from the Teach for All network in Africa have been working together during the last year and a half to implement a teacher development project in Africa that has thrown a very positive result. Amazing, we could say, if we consider that it has been running in the middle of the pandemic. In 2020, we managed to train together more than 15,000 teachers in 3 countries, and this year we plan to reach 13,000 more in 5 countries. The training strategy was defined for teachers from vulnerable environments, but we believe that the skills they are developing can apply to any teacher around the world. This is a powerful example of how education innovation can happen anywhere. Don't you think that we should all learn from those experiences?
It's so true. I think we've found that when we center the most vulnerable, the most marginalized kids, the kids at the edges in our efforts, then we make sure that all of our innovations and all of our efforts can meet the needs of all kids. And we've seen that over and over. You know, I think again about this example of Kim Sabria, a teacher in the Spanish program that's part of the Teach for All network, who pioneered this incredible innovation as he worked with some of the most underserved kids in his city where he taught, and started trying to figure out, how do I leverage video to help the kids be more engaged? And what came from that is now EdPuzzle, an app that, you know, 80% of the kids in my own country here in the US and 35 million kids around the world, some of the most marginalized kids and some of the most privileged kids are benefiting from. So again, I think our collective welfare improves when we center our efforts on equity and ensuring that that the kids who face the most challenges have the greatest supports.
That's great. The reason why we are now having this conversation in a virtual format is that we are still in the middle of COVID pandemic that constrains some of our day-to-day activities, but also because the pandemic has changed the way we do things, the way we meet, the way we work, and also the way we learn. But I believe that schools and teachers keep on playing a central role. I recently read a document produced by the Futures of Education Commission of UNESCO that said, while learning may occur widely, there is nothing spontaneous about education. Education requires intentionality, planning, and systematization because it does not happen naturally or spontaneously. Wendy, what is your vision and your hope for the future of education?
You know, my hope is that all of us in education, all of our teachers and educators, understand that really the future is in our hands. I think in this era that has shown us just how uncertain the world is, just how much the challenges facing us are growing, it just becomes so clear that the kids in our classrooms today will need to be developing as leaders who can solve these increasingly complex problems, can navigate change and uncertainty. So that means that we need to be developing them with the agency, the awareness, the critical thinking and problem-solving skills, the sense of empathy and connectedness and well-being to live into that and to shape a better world and a better future. So my hope is that we can leverage the tremendous possibilities that have emerged. I mean, even as this era has exacerbated the inequities and really compounded the challenges facing the communities in which we're working around the world, we have also seen so many new possibilities, the potential to leverage technology, the potential to engage students and parents much more deeply in shaping the learning experience, the potential to much better integrates a focus on student well-being and social emotional development at every turn of every school day. And so my hope is that we'll leverage all those new possibilities to reimagine the whole system so that this generation growing up today and future generations are all the more likely to thrive and to build a better future.
It's a great dream, Wendy. I also dream in that sense that we can leverage all we have learned in this pandemic. It has been a real pleasure. You're really inspiring. This conversation has been really enriching for us. I hope that we keep on sharing knowledge and experience among both organizations so that our common work keeps on improving the quality of education for all. Wendy, thank you very much.
Thank you so much for such an enriching partnership and learning journey. We so look forward to the future together.
Thank you very much.